Well, congratulations, Villanova. Played really well today. They really had bookends. You know, they started off really well and they finished really well and hit some big threes early in the game. And obviously the three big threes late in the game were a lot to overcome. So they played well, made a lot of shots, and congratulations to them. I thought we did a nice job of getting back in it. You know, a double-digit lead to Villanova is like a 30-point deficit to a lot of teams because they don't turn it over, they don't hurry up, they just take time. And we really did a good job there in the last several minutes to give ourselves a chance to go into overtime. So I'm proud of how the team responded there in a real tough situation. And it's not consolation for them, but just really proud of what they did today and all year. So, that'll do it.
About questions for any of the three student athletes? Just raise your hand and we'll get a microphone to you.
Macy, did you see them as a team that was going to take 38 threes today?
Well, we knew they were a three-point shooting team, and I thought we were the own aggressor on the defensive end at the beginning, and we gave up too many threes at the beginning, and we just had to overcome a big deficit in the second half, and I thought we did a good job. We gave ourselves a chance, but made some down the stretch.
Madison, they got off to such a good start there. Was it tough to overcome that?
I mean, when a team gets off to a start like that, the big thing was just to stay composed, and we did a great job of that. We just kind of chipped away throughout the whole game and gave ourselves a chance there at the end in overtime, and just didn't quite go the way we wanted to. A couple execution things at the end there, but really proud just of how this team came back from that deficit.
Macy, what was it about Villanova's defense, especially in the first half, that made it so difficult to get any room and get an offense going?
I'd just say we were just stagnant that first half. We weren't really passing around the horn, or we weren't being aggressive, you know, making them help. And I give them credit defensively. They made us get out of a rhythm a little bit in the first half, and it was tough.
Ellie, I hate to ask you a question because these guys get another chance next year, but this was almost a miracle finish the way the regulation ended. It certainly was, and will be kind of a memorable night for you, even though you lost.
Yeah, I think it's every game was memorable wearing the Jackrabbit uniform, and it's obviously a sad moment knowing that this is my last time, but I know that this team and this program has so much to look forward to, and we have such great people surrounding us, and I know that in the next couple of years, like, these girls will really carry on the kind of Jackrabbit legacy that all the players before have built up.
Madison, just what was going through your head? What did you see in that, you know, three at the end of regulation?
We just, you know, we executed our play really well, set good screens, moved the ball effectively, and then just had to get it up there.
Anything else for any of the three?
Macy, it sure had to feel good to be back out on the NCAA floor after being hurt last year. I know it's hard to look ahead, but this program just seems to be getting better and better and better, wouldn't you say?
Yeah. I'd say we took many steps forward here, and I'm proud of our team, and we've had a really great year. It's tough with this loss, but, you know, I'm proud of every single one of them. We had a great year, and we're excited for next year and to get better in the offseason.
I guess what was it about Villanova's defense that you thought maybe made it difficult for you guys to get into a rhythm offensively?
Well, I mean, things didn't come easy, but really for three quarters we played better offensively than maybe it felt like. I think we outscored them in second, third, and fourth. We shot 47% from the field for the game. We had two more field goals than they had, made two more free throws than they made, and we had to foul some down the stretch to put them there. I really thought offensively we played okay. We just 16 threes was the difference. You know, and like I said, the start was really tough because we got down, I think, you know, and they got some confidence going, and then late they hit the threes. And you know, two players were 12 of 25 from the three-point line. We just couldn't – we didn't get to them the way we need to. And to their credit, they really spaced the floor well. They passed the ball well. They shoot it well. So they did, you know, what Villanova does very well. So that's not a surprise, some of the things I just talked about. But they were just a little bit better and made some big shots when they needed to. So they're a hard team just to, you know, put a lot of points on the board again, 74 points. I know there's an overtime, but that's actually, you know, pretty good against them. But the three-point shot was really the difference, I thought, in the game.
Ironically, it was a banked Stacy Sizek shot for you guys that sent the game to overtime. Did you almost have the feeling that when you made that shot that momentum had finally turned the corner? Because it seemed like you guys were fighting this uphill battle. You were behind the whole game.
Never led, I don't think. I don't think we ever led. Did it say that? I don't think we did. If we did, it wasn't long. Yeah, you know, it was a different play, but same result. Wasn't a lot of time left, so it wasn't it was a tough shot. You know, it wasn't like it was clean look. She did a great job just to get it off. And we go 3 of 16 from the three-point line. Take that one out of it, and you go 2 of 15. We're just a better shooting team than that, and we just couldn't get any of them to really go. After we made that, we had a really good look from Macy to start the overtime, and I was right behind it, let it go. I thought it was online and in. I thought we could get some momentum, and we just couldn't get one to fall. And, you know, sure enough, they go down and hit a couple. So, yeah, that three-point line was the difference.
I guess I'll ask you the same thing I did Ellie and Macy, for that matter. I know at a time like this, it's maybe kind of hard to put in perspective where things are at with the program, but it does really seem like you're just building and building and building on what you've been doing.
Yeah, I mean, I think so. I really do. Feel really good about the season we had. When you get to this point, you can still be a really good team and lose a game. You know, and had we came back and found a way to win that, you know, Villanova would have been a really good team that lost a game, you know. So, you know, tonight isn't a reflection of where your program at. It's a reflection of how the game went. I really feel good about where we're at. And the steps we take at this point, I just wish we could take, you know, big leaps, but they're going to be small steps. And I think I've said that for a while now. And this year we took, I think, another step. We played top teams in the country well. Put ourselves in position to have a really good seed here today. Didn't capitalize on it the way we want, but I think it's a good direction we're on and definitely a bright future.
Prior to the game, there must have been some things that you thought, you know, that potentially you would be a little bit vulnerable against this team. Is that how it shook out? Was it the three-pointers?
Yeah, I mean, we were probably a little bit more worried just about some of their cutting and them getting to the basket, and I think probably we're too passive in the first few minutes, and that was our, you know, our thought as coaches. It wasn't like the players didn't handle the moment and didn't, you know, do what was expected. We were probably just a little bit too soft on the perimeter, and they got some rhythm and got going, and I thought as we started to get a little more assertive in the second half, I thought we were more disruptive, and I thought we did take some things away. So, you know, that was players did, I think, what we were asking them to, and we probably didn't get them in a good enough position there early in the game to get some momentum going. But it still is, it's still at this level when you play close games, make and miss shots is such a tough thing. Makes you second guess, makes you feel like you did the right thing, and ultimately it just didn't go our way.